This is your weekly trip to paradise, Louisiana style, with Gary Risponi. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Murphy Law Firm, Veterans Health Foundation, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament. Louisiana State Parks, Relief Windows, Visit Baton Rouge, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Welcome to this almost springtime edition of Paradise, Louisiana. I'm Gary Risponi, and as you can see, no special hosts this week. A lot of them were supposed to be here, a couple were supposed to be here, and all of a sudden, business took them somewhere else. So, but may make all this talking a little bit shorter and bring you more action this week, so we're going to break on it. I got to make my annual rabbit hunt with my homeboys, and JJ and them set one up in St. Gabriel. Beautiful woods, beautiful things, but just so happy they made an earlier hunt, and I don't know why, but there was signs, but we didn't get to kill before five rabbits. I think we got some pretty good shots. My cameraman that day, Richard Lemoyne, I think he got a few good shots of rabbits running between his legs and stuff, so. We're going to see that, but we got to talk to him, talk to Mr. Honore, one of the legends out there. He's been hunting all his life in this club. His son, and we had three generations there, you know, and nothing I like better than when you're hunting rabbits or any kind of hunting at that, is when you got three generations. And that's what we've tried to promote on this show. Keep a hunting legacy going, fishing legacy, outdoor legacy, conservation. So we try to do it all. I don't know what kind of job we do, but we're gonna keep trying to do our best. Now, a couple of things that I did besides the rabbit hunt. I made another trip to Delacroix. I'm not gonna call it a black cloud day. I went with Captain Jack Payne, Sweetwater. There was a few fish caught that day. The wind for 2 days that I was there, I got there early Thursday and fished Friday. It was just, wouldn't let up. It was just blowing out of southwest. And then it sort of went west. And y'all know what, I can't tell y'all, but I'll tell y'all more about what the captain say. When the wind's out of west, it's not too good for anything over there, besides muddying it up. But knowing Jack, his plan too, they got them always dependable redfish. And he got on a point, we was using live shrimp because we had them, but dead shrimp, whatever, jig head. And we got some video of that. I got news reports. We got event calendar. Tournament report is stacked up right now with big tournaments, little tournaments, tournaments coming up. So we'll mention that in that segment. The fishing report is scattered. We're getting a lot of reports from freshwater. And we'll talk more about that when we get in the fishing report. A lot of them coming from private ponds or lakes, and we're calling them private. But some of them you can ask permission. Sometimes they're off the rivers or pits and stuff. Yeah. This time of year, you're really gonna have to be careful too, because the river's up and all those pits, and the river's dangerous, still real dangerous. So if you're fishing off the bank and want to catch catfish, you got to be careful. We got that fishing report, and then tournament report. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Paradise, Louisiana, coming to you from Bedrons, Boudin Cajun Meats in Port Allen, Louisiana.
There's no better way to cool down this summer than with a delicious, thirst-quenching Polar Pop Cup from Circle K. The Polar Pop Cup is the coolest way to beat the heat. Fill your Polar Pop Cup up with the flavors you crave and crushed or cubed ice. Nothing stays cold longer, so you can stay refreshed all day long. Stop in Circle K today for an ice-cold Polar Pop Cup. Polar Pop Cup, only at Circle K. Take it easy.
Stay tuned for more from Paradise, Louisiana, for our annual rabbit hunt.
For the thirsty, for those who hang out in packs, for heroes, for sidekicks, for those who see the glass half empty, for those who see it half full, for those on the right, for those on the left, for those with nicknames, for those with curves, for people that cycle, for people that recycle, for BFFs, for frenemies, for those with style, for lovers, for families, for big families, for everyone.
One thing I like about these annual hunts that I use, go back and do it, we do it every year. JJ's been putting it together. I want to wish his dad to get well. He'd been in the hospital with a form of leukemia, but he got out. He was supposed to get out the day that we hunted. So we hope he's home. We hope he's doing better. Mr. Campbell, take care. Your son did a great job. And what was the best? The best non-Sicilian Italian spaghetti I ever eat. And I can't go tell you the recipe, but my buddy Big Mike, man, what when we come out of the woods, what a treat that we had with that spaghetti. It was made with deer sausage and ground beef, both. So it was tremendous. Thank you, Mike. So let's go see. It might be short, it might be long. I really don't know how much good video we had.
Mr. Tyrone Honore, what a legend. We're over here in St. Gabriel. How long you been hunting rabbits, Mr. Tyrone?
I was about 9 years old.
9 years old. Where did you hunt at mostly? Are you all over or out in St. Gabriel and different places?
Yeah, Plaquemine, well, over there.
Yeah.
I'm there.
You had a lot of girls. And you had two boys. You brought them both, the boys up hunting. What about the girls? Did you ever take the girls hunting and fishing?
Nah, they don't fool that day.
We ready to go this morning?
Huh?
We ready to go?
Oh, yeah.
What you hear about these dogs they got? Them kids got all kind of dogs.
Oh, yeah. They nice dogs. We hunted the other week with them.
What's the most rabbit hunt dogs you ever hunted with? I used to hunt with five or six when I was coming. My daddy. Sometimes we'd be down to four. These guys, they hunt them in shifts. They got 20-something dogs. What's the most you ever hunt with?
Oh, I hunted like with 7 or 8, but I used to have 3. Used to run.
I hope we don't black out them. They're supposed to have a lot of rabbits here. You ready?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Honore.
Mandel Featherston, Mansfield, Texas.
Jordan Hatch, Lytle, Louisiana. Mandel Jr., Nashville, Texas.
Tyler Franklin, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Michael Hudson, Baton Rouge, Louisiana, representing Benton, Louisiana.
J.J. Campbell, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Tyrone Honore Jr., I'm from Irwinville, Louisiana.
I'm John Hatch, and I'm from Irwinville, Louisiana.
And they are.
Hey, be looking, Mr. Gay. They coming around this way.
They got it? There you go. That's what we're looking for. They got another one up. Let's go, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good job.
Just begun.
Here he is, coming at you, get ready. Here he is, you see. Hold on, you shoot me. Hold on. Where'd he stop? Yeah, I see him. He's coming. He's coming. Get ready. Get ready. Hold on. There he is.
That's a big brow patch. Get him out of there. There he went. Went that way.
You tuned into Paradise, Louisiana on an annual rabbit hunt. This is what they call a lapin. Shot him on the fly.
Hi, I'm John Jackson, and you know we always say we gather our groceries out the bayou. Whether it's freshwater, saltwater, catfish, redfish, you have tons of choices when it comes to fish in Louisiana. But when I fry fish, there's only one choice, and that's Louisiana fish fry. My new favorite, the Cajun fish fry, has the perfect amount of cornmeal, corn flour, and the perfect mix of spices that really bring the heat. Hey, if you're craving Cajun, go look for the bright red bag at your local grocers. Bring home the taste of Louisiana with Louisiana Fish Fry.
I'm Brett Favre. As a quarterback in the NFL, if I didn't stay focused, I ended up on my back or worse. Even the smallest distraction could make a good play or offensive drive come to an end. When you're in a car, the smallest distraction could end much more than a drive. It could end someone's life. Just like I refuse to lose on the field, I refuse to lose someone I love to distracted driving. And you should too. Focus on the road. Don't drive distracted. A message from Farm Bureau Insurance.
When my wife and I started Relief Windows, what our goal was to give a quality job to a homeowner. Everybody's scared of contractors. We wanted to change the mold of what that is. The reason why you should pick Relief Windows to do your renovation of your home, windows, doors, hardy plank, or siding, is because of the experience, quality service of our company. We're gonna show up on time, we're gonna do the job right. The job's not done until you're happy and we're happy. We believe you deserve a quality job.
I done made a many good trips with you over the years. We had a couple of black guy trips because you was trying to help that boy from Michigan and we run aground. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember.
The only time, and you begged me not to show it on TV and I did. You called me last week and you said, get your butt down here. We're catching fish right now, not far from landing. You got sick. I black clouded you on the phone.
Yeah, I had a little stomach illness. I don't know what happened. I got sick that night, and about 2 o'clock in the morning, I started feeling a little better. I was too tired to go.
Well, what did I say? KD, I come down with KD. You told us where to go, and we caught fish, and we left. And you said, I want you to do it with me. You come back. Today, prediction is bad. No wind. I mean, too much wind coming from the west. What did they say about a wind from the west in Delacroix?
It's tough. I didn't know it was going to be west. They said south, southwest. So if it changes to the west, we'll probably be in a little trouble, but we'll figure something out.
Yeah, but people coming in as early as supposed to. It's overcast, just like it was last Wednesday. We did good. So I want to qualify this. We going on a bad day, so I'm not going to blame him if it's bad. He said we coming. The only way you're going to find out is if you go. Am I correct?
That's right.
So we're getting ready to go. I got my good buddy Ken Lambert on camera, and he ain't catching nothing right now in the Pontchartrain area, but he's always looking. So we'll be back. We're getting ready to get out there. You ready to go?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's get life jackets on. Let's go.
So this is one of the colors I've been using. You know, the water's a little dirtier today, so I might switch to a little bit darker bait, but when it's been clear, this is the color that's been working the best.
What made you think those, what turned those trout on all of a sudden? The water cleared up? It ain't real clear today, but.
I think this year, you know, our main problem was all the fresh water that was coming in through the Mardi Gras Pass. And then it was a good shrimp season, you know, from Lake John down towards False River. Any further south than that, there was hardly any shrimp. And I think this year we had all that fresh water coming in, and the fresh water was coming in. Then we had all the shrimpers that were hitting every single pipeline out here or canal. They were dragging for shrimp. And then next thing, they were re-sinking the twin pipeline. They were undermining the pipeline, setting it back down on the bottom, then backfilling on top of it. And that just destroyed the water. I mean, it was just chocolate milk everywhere. There was no place that you could get where the water wasn't dirty. And I think we had, not normal Delacroix standard fishing, you know. We didn't have nearly the amount of speckled trout that normally migrate into the interior this year. And that has all to do with the freshwater, because, you know, a lot of fish come in from Baker's Bay area, come up the Oak River, and then they, you know, filtrate throughout all the interior of Delacroix. Then, you know, you got them coming up Gentilly, False River, stuff like that. But this year, you know, with the river, the shrimp in the industry going on, and then we had all that undermount, you know, when they were resetting the pipeline down, that just had a lot of things screwed up. And then when the fishing did get right, we had bad weather, you know, when, you know, and then if the weather's not right and doesn't clear up, it's hard to catch speckled trout when the water's really dirty. So, you know, here lately, the water's gotten a lot better, and the fishing has picked up tremendously, but.
That's good. Can't tell me what's been the problems around the Pontchartrain and Bourne and all that. What is it, muddy water? What's been the problem, the wind?
Most of the Pearl River's got that whole Wrigley's area. Halfway down the ICW, you gotta go almost to the beginning of the bypass canal to start getting good water. And then from there all the way to the wall, and then the Mr. Goat Canal, that's the best water right now. But everything from the bridges south to the Wrigley's, just real, real muddy. And of course the wind and the fronts moving through every 3 or 4 days, rain, high winds. So it's really, all of it together has just made it very, very difficult. Most people are doing bass. We're coming into that time of the year where the old timers call them lake runners. We call them chinkapin, but that's gonna get started, and that'll be good in the canals, the marsh canals, Gohagan Canal, Cockahoe minnows. So we're in that time of the year. It's almost like another transition period.
Trout, and this hit me by accident, I guess. We're gonna find him sooner or not, huh? Am I right, Jack?
Okay.
We'll be right back.
this is it. In the bad windy days, you gotta resort to other, you know, activity, and this is it, redfish. And there's plenty of them guys. Ah. On this end of the lake, I know it's a pain in the butt when you're fishing with the wind beating up against the bank with the waves and everything, but this is where the bait and everything gets shoved, and this is where the fish, you know, they're swimming down these shorelines looking for wounded minnows, crabs, whatever they come across. But all we've been, you know, today's been a rough day with the weather, but we've been catching some nice redfish, we saw 4 or 5 trout, so it wasn't a half bad day considering we've only been out here a few hours.
Jack, here we are. Dead in the middle of February, okay? The last 2 weeks, people catching fish. We even had people come in today with 35, 40 trout. But it was tough, you know. You found a few trout, but it kept getting rougher and rougher and rougher. And normally in the wintertime, or like this time, that's what you like to do. You don't have to get up at daylight. You don't have to get out here real early. And it warms up, you catch fish. Right now, somebody coming to Delacro in the next few weeks. How do they prepare for Delacro?
Just if you want to catch redfish, poppy cork with a jig head. And if you want speckled trout, I usually use a little 4 carbon lead, about 2.5 foot, a little split shot above my shrimp, and usually about 2.5 foot under a popping cork. That's all you got to do to rig up the fish down here. And then, you know, just come down and we'll try to get you pointed out on a map where to go. You know, the guys that caught the 40 or 35 trout today said they were fishing right at the Twin Pipeline where it meets Four Horse Lake, which is a very common spot. Lots of people catch fish there. It's a easy spot to get to if it's your first trip down there. You just run straight down Tower Bluff and we'll show you how to get there. It's about, you know, 8 miles from here one way.
Where the places you got, really got to be careful because you run in shallow water and run aground.
You know, all back in the graveyard can be a little sketchy if you don't know where you're going, but since Hurricane Katrina, those shallow spots have gotten, the spots where they used to have land have gotten deep enough the way you can kind of run around. It's not so bad like it used to be. You know, a few, 3 or 4 years ago, if you messed up, you were really getting stuck. Like I said, unfortunately, it's just washing away so fast now that, you know, the bottom went from this like that to it's deep now. It's not as bad.
If somebody's watching the weather and want to come to Delacro, what's the best weather for Delacro? It's when you might as well pack up and come because you're going to have some kind of success.
You want to fish with east, northeast winds, southeast winds. You know, when it starts getting westerly to northwest, it's all redfish kind of day. You can still come and catch some redfish, but the trout are gonna, you know, shut down. And, you know, this year we've been having a lot of fresh water, so the water's been staying dirty a lot longer than normal after a front. So you know, you want to catch some east southeast winds, and I would suggest you come down to Delacro, and if the wind's blowing, it's supposed to be blowing 25 or 30, I might suggest you stay home anyway.
Thank you again. You've always been a buddy.
Oh, no problem.
I'm going to get back. Hey, you beat the black cloud. We didn't skunk, but you told us a little something.
It was a hard day. You know, anytime you're fishing in 20-plus mile-an-hour winds, it's hard.
You want to go get a football?
Yeah, let's go get
last
one.
Time?
I'm ready.
You're watching Paradise from Louisiana. Thanks to Ken Lambert. No camera today. Thank you, buddy.
The perfect event calls for the perfect spread of authentic Cajun cuisine. And Catering Cajun has the planners, packages, and chefs to ensure your event is long remembered. For weddings, corporate lunches, or anything in between, give us a call.
Well, the reason why I would recommend him because he's trustworthy. And I mean, attention and love and respect of who you are, what you are, and the purpose why you came, he honors that. Once you're with Murphy, you got a friend.
best part about being a member of a Touchstone Energy Cooperative is that it's your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. That's the power of your co-op membership. Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
For the thirsty, for those who hang out in packs, for heroes, for sidekicks, for those who see the glass half empty, for those who see it half full, for those on the right, for those on the left, for those with nicknames, for those with curves, for people that cycle, for people that recycle, for BFFs, for frenemies, for those with style, for lovers, for families, for big families, for everyone.
If you've been watching TV, you've been reading the paper, it's baseball season. College baseball season, a few years ago we did a tournament with some of the legends in college baseball. We had Coach Cater, Coach Maneri, and the real legend down in New Orleans. Tell me his name real quick. I was trying to think. Right. Look, he ain't been in the news lately. I almost forgot him. Coach Ron Maestri. And he's a true fisherman. So this is a little something. What a fun day with these guys. And I'm talking about they all competitive.
Roger Cador, Southern University.
Ron Maestri, University of New Orleans.
And I'm Paul Maneri, LSU.
We have over 100 years of coaching experience, but today we're going to go out and have fun. I'm going to push Roger in the water, I'm going to lip Maneri with a hook, and I'm going to catch all the fish.
Guess maybe not.
Man, hook that thing where he can't get it off.
You're not serious, I have to take it, make a practice cast in front of all these people? It's like golf. It's
wait
like
a minute.
I got to have some protection.
Oh, okay.
What's that
say? It says fishing salt water with Coach Maneri. It's a,
oh,
it's a safety.
Oh, yeah, no.
It's a safety measure. Oh, thank God. Oh, okay.
This guy.
If he's going to cast something, I got to.
Oh,
oh my. No, I'm all right. My head's fast, Maneri.
It's a good thing my confidence is not that fragile, okay?
And as we're getting ready, it looks like somebody's a little concerned about control of that casting.
You're watching Paradise, Louisiana.
Get a helping hand.
Both of us help you, Paul.
Thank you.
We didn't want him to fall.
We're successful so far. Nobody has fallen in yet.
There's a spick?
Only 49 left.
Oh, okay, we're right, 49 left.
Oh my goodness. This is a fighter. Probably about 1 pound. Andre, where you at? Oh my goodness. What is it? Oh my goodness.
It's tough.
Holy cow!
Are you ready?
Oh my goodness!
Yep.
Oh my goodness!
Bring it up a little. Bring it up a little. There you go. Get it up on the arm. Bring it on the.
Watch your rod tip. When your rod tip starts coming up a little bit.
Oh my God!
His head comes out of the water.
Pick the rod up.
Get his head on the water. Hold it up. Bring your rod to the right. Lay your rod to the right a little bit. Bring it down. There you go.
Oh!
All right, the three college baseball coaches do during the offseason.
Oh,
I'll give you a hint. Coco Dre. And he's coachable, too.
Andre, you are the best. Look at that thing. Holy cow. Did I really get it? Oh my goodness. How much that thing weighed?
Look at you, Paul. Golly.
Wow, was that fun? I'm exhausted.
Hey, wait that son of a gun, because I'm going to catch one bigger. We got a bet.
Not bad for a rookie.
Andre was coaching me.
I tell my customers, I said, all your friends are going to be hollering and telling you what to do. If I'm not hollering at you, keep doing what you're doing.
Okay. That's what I'm thinking.
Ron, where's yours? Maneri always, you know, he always goes for the drama. We catch 40 and he catches one big one.
That was like one of the greatest experiences of my life. But I got to tell you, I have such a burn in my arm right now. I have got to get in that weight room, get back in shape. That's addicting.
It is. Right, I'm re-rigging, we'll get you right back in there.
Are you serious? Do I have to do that again?
You know, let's face it, he really hit a grand slam in the first inning with his first catch. I mean, he had to feel good because he was down a little. May Street and I were catching fish. He hadn't landed anything, hadn't even gotten a bite yet. So we're happy that he caught the big one, the big red. And now he's really trying to burn us into us, let us know that he's ahead with size.
Hey, Roger.
Size do matter, and let me just say that.
Watch out, Paul.
It's nothing but a small one.
Nowhere near where you are.
There you go. Oh, that's a nice shot.
I won in Omaha. That was winning in Omaha, that one. You beat Nichols State. You beat Nichols State in the midweek game. I beat Texas there with that one.
Stop him. Straight up.
Ooh. Big fish. Funny. These are good fillets there, Maneri.
Yeah, fillets, Maneri.
Thank you, Ron. You're leaving me a trout to catch. What's that for? Keep it fast.
I think so, bro. I don't know. I've got to get it out of the water to see. Oh, I got away!
Oh. Keep rolling.
Yep. It was a bigger than that bullfish you caught. At least 17 pounds.
That's what I mean. It takes skill to finish the job and close it out. You got to have good coaching and you got to follow the coaching.
You want to see my boy?
Oh my God! Look at the size of that thing. Are you kidding me?
Man, you were really doing that.
Aaron Nola would be proud to catch a fish like that.
He's a fisherman?
Oh yeah.
You got the last time since you opened it, huh?
Yeah, it got a little bigger. It's growing.
Can you bring this one in? Just hold it for me for a minute. I'm exhausted. I gotta send a picture of that to Nola. He's gonna love that.
Come on, buddy.
One thing about taking the coaches from the ballpark to the bayou, they bring along their competitiveness.
Hey, you can't fish sitting down, Paul. I know Maneri, when we beat him, he'll feel bad, but it's competition, you know? And it's like out here. He's not getting the back of this corner of this boat where I'm catching all the fish. He's going in the water before I let him get back here and get this spot.
This is a great spot. I caught a lot of fish here today.
I'm really impressed by those two guys. You know, the veteranness of Roger and Mace. It's obvious they're not doing any recruiting. They're just fishing all the time. So that probably bodes well for us in the competition next spring. But, you know, today, I'm just blown away by how knowledgeable they are and what great technique. Every time Mace throws the line in the water, he comes back with a trout. You know, Roger gets the... Excuse me.
Oh, no. Oh, how did I do that?
But anyway.
At least he came back.
What is it? What you doing? It's a big one.
Still even worse. Even worse.
Right now. Oh my gosh. Look at that, Mace.
You guys catching all of the
rod. Mace.
You know, this is just a great day that you can come out like this. We're catching fish. We got great fellowship. And I'm excited.
They have a blast. It was fun. The trip I get with those kinds of guys are fun for me. Yeah, they enjoyed every bit of it.
When Roger casts his line, it hits the water about half the time, okay? But when he does get it in the water, it's amazing. He's got great technique, great feel. Mace, he's just a veteran. For 28 years, he's been doing nothing but bass fishing. So now he wants to get back on the field. Not sure how his bass fishing and casting techniques are going to help translate into victories for the privateers, but we'll see.
I tell you, it's been a lot of fun, and we've caught some fish, which makes it even better. So we've been having good nature ripping each other up, and you know, Paul Maneri caught that big old 10-pound fish,
what?
Allegedly on the first try.
Well, first of all, that was a kamikaze. You know, that fish wanted to die because Coach Maneri's sitting over there. Look at him. He looks like he's GQ. Look at his pants. Now, who would have a pair of pants like that out here fishing? He's got the big Panama hat. He thinks he's GQ. Roger and I have got quantity. We probably got 15 to 20 fish to his one big one.
The memory might be a little fudgy, but who's caught redfish today? I caught two. Remember the little one?
It's good nature, though. Once we leave here, it'll be all over. Except for that fish. I'm sure the pictures will be all over the internet at some point. But other than that, we're going to leave this behind. We'll compete against each other during the course of the year. And we'll certainly remind each other of the day we were out here and had some fun.
This is just amazing. You know, anybody's never done this, to come out here into the Gulf and fish, and, you know, off the coast of Louisiana. You're missing something. This is a bucket list item if there's ever been one. And when you get to finally pull in that big fish, I'm telling you, when I pulled that 14-pound redfish in, it was one of the greatest thrills of my life, without exaggeration. That was amazing. What an experience. And you just can't experience that laying on your couch. You got to get out here and fish.
Does it get better than this? I'll tell you, this is what Louisiana is about. The water, the fishing, the hunting, there's none better. And it's a time where we can relax and have fun. Being out in the sun, fresh water, it's awesome.
I just made it. Let me help Coach Main Street.
I'm sure that's got to be the biggest fish they've seen around here in a long time.
It is. Oh. Hold up, Paul. Let's pull it a little closer.
Yeah. My legs aren't long enough.
All right.
Success.
We had to help him get out. He's so much energy. He's getting that fish in the boat, you know? Hey, Sammy. Good to see you, buddy.
I can't imagine a day without music. You go downtown, you can find some music. You come uptown, you can find some music. Monday night, they got music. Every night of the week, there's music somewhere. Baton Rouge is a place where it's easy to make friends, it's easy to hear some music, and it's easy to come back. We got the music, we got the food, and we got good people. So with that combination, you can't lose, right? Yeah, I'ma
come to Louisiana. Ask me about my Tempur-Pedic.
Ask me how fast I fall asleep.
Why not talk to someone who's sleeping on the most highly recommended bed in America?
Ask me about staying asleep.
Tempur-Pedic owners are more satisfied than owners of any traditional mattress brand.
Ask me how it feels after 10 years.
Tempur-Pedic, the most highly recommended bed in America.
Ask about Tempur-Pedic at Olin's, where you know you always get the guaranteed low price.
Olin's is the only store in Baton Rouge and Lafayette with the full line of Tempur-Pedics.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, and almost like Saturday Night Live. Here's the news update right now coming from Paradise, Louisiana. I want to remind everybody right now, you know, in their April meeting, the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries, they already got it out. They planning on cutting the teal season limit from 6 to 4. So I've already gave you my opinion. I don't like the idea. I've talked to some biologists. They don't see it's a need for it. But for some reason, they looking at it. They always approved it, but the final approval will be coming at the April meeting. Be sure and get your opinion in. You can call the Wildlife and Fisheries. You can email the Wildlife and Fisheries. You can get in touch with Larry Reynolds. You can get in touch with even some of the commissioners. If you know the commissioners, you get in touch with them and take care of that. And the same, Ryan, this Thursday night. Now, you'll be watching this on Wednesday. You're watching on Thursday. You're too late. They got a meeting in Abbeville. DU has got the State of the Ducks. Anybody's invited to be Thursday at 6 p.m. at Magnum Place. The Hog Rodeo, reminding you, your hog hunters, dog hunters, a little festival going on. Another one has been in Abbeville at the meat place. That'll be Friday, Saturday, Sunday. The weigh-in is 2 o'clock. Sunday, the final weigh-in, and a lot of other activities going there. Louisiana Sportsman Show, the big show coming on. Won't be coming up in, I think it's the middle of March right now, you see a date, be coming up. Don't forget it, put it on your calendar. You don't want to miss it. You know how it is with Lamar Dixon. This is the big one. It's 3 or 4 days. It's nothing to be there that you would need, you can find it there. So, dreams come true. I just got a newsletter. They postponed their clay shoot. It was supposed to be earlier. It's moved back to June 8th. So I give them more time. They looking for sponsors. They have sponsors. It's gonna be going on. It's be going on over there in the Lafayette area. You can get in touch or go to the website, Dreams Come True, and you can find out more. You can find out who to donate to or join the shoot. I think that's all I got in the news, but what I'm going to do right now, and to save time, I'm going to jump into the tournament report. Okay, we got a bunch of tournaments coming up. I'm going to mention them right now. Number one in my heart and everybody else's is the Merge Centers tournament coming up March 2nd. It'll be at Dry Runs Landing. Just keep it in your mind. Now, that's a festival. That's a day. They're going to have bands there. They're going to have what I really like. They start early in the morning with cooking. The wild game cook-off. They give prizes, all that. The weigh-in will be later in the afternoon, I think about 3 o'clock. Bands, booths, whatever's going on, will be all at Dry Runs this year. And I remind y'all fishermen, you can't go in the marsh and buy Gibson, but you can fish Bateman Island and some of those other places besides the Spillway and the Barrette side. So that's March 2nd. That's a big one. And believe it or not, high as the river is and high as the Chaffalai and all the places around the Mississippi still coming up, they still catching fish in some of these areas. So I think that most of these fishing couple of weeks gonna be coming from the Barrette area, and that's where a lot of them being caught right now. When we see in the fishing report, we had the see what other bass tournaments we got coming up. Oh, we got The high school tournament was this past weekend. It was at Henderson. It was hosted by the West Bassmaster Louisiana High School Tournament. I got those reports for you here in a minute. I'm going to remind you the next one's going to be March 2nd, and that's going to be at Toledo Bend. That's also a West one. But they had 127 boats that went out to Henderson, and it was just a tremendous day. 49 of the 127 teams caught fish. It was rough. The water's up. It's hard to find clear water. But most of those kids, but some of these mainstays here, and you know their parents, you know. First place was Michael Bonadonna and Greg Diamond. They had a 5-fish limit, $12.99. That's a good one this time of year, believe me, in Henderson. Second from Central High School. By the way, Michael and him from Brule. Second was from Central High School, Wyatt Ensminger and Dawson Andrews. They had 9.28. Third place was from Walker, Louisiana, Hanson Chaney and Bronson Beck. They had 8.35. Big Bass was Hayden Rutledge from Natchitoches Central High School. In Natchitoches, they had 4.5. The top team was Team Brule. They had three best weights average. The total 21.32. The Elite was the past week, and we know we have a bunch of guys fishing the Elite. The overall winner was Paul Mueller, 69 pounds. He won $100,000. Second place was Chris Zaldin at 68.2. You believe that? 0.8 of a pound. He dropped down from $100,000 to $25,000. Third was Keith Combs with 66.1, and he took home $20,000. You can see the list. The all of Louisiana anglers, Caleb Summerall. What's so strange about this? All of Louisiana boys come in 42nd, 43rd, 44th, 45th. Now, this is how they finished. Caleb Summerall was 42nd, 25.5. Skylar Hamilton was 25.5. Brandon Lester was 25.1. Derek Hudnall was 24.13. All took home $2,500. Them guys all fishing together, what? You wonder what happened. You know, all got 25 pounds, or almost 25 pounds. It was just amazing. We didn't get to talk to them. They just got back in late Sunday. So I'm going to get one of them guys. We're going to find out what happened. But they had a leader coming up just one after another. So they don't get much time home. And that's why you see a group of Louisiana boys. I had another group of boys were fishing the Bass Pro Circuit, and I didn't get any reports on it, so I don't know what to tell y'all. But my nephew, Quentin Capo, he come in too. He placed in the money with, he had 20.12, and Robbie Lutuso, who had real good last week, 15.4. That's two tournaments I know. I got another tournament. We mentioned last year a bunch of them, a little local type tournament. It's called Boone & Shoots. Is that Falls River? Falls River this time of year usually produce some big fish. And we have a bunch of tournaments coming up. They got the KC tournament coming up there in a week or so. So y'all can look at the websites, look at tourism and call the tourism in there in Point Coupee and see what's coming up. There's a bunch of tournaments coming up at Falls River. Buster Roy and Ron Fibe had 18.45, good stringer. Second place with Wayne Majors and Shannon Fairchild with 16 pounds and something. Brad Bowie, Chuck Ballard. All these are old Falls River names. I don't know if you look at these guys, fish Falls River a lot of it for fun and all the tournaments, you see these names in there all the time. They had 15 pounds. Gene Andre, by the way, Gene's doing better. He's been fighting his cancer. He's doing good. Him and Chris Mitchell had 15 pounds. David Pluckett, Dal Crumholt had 13 pounds. And Big Bass, starting to get up big. Ryan Fibe, 7.63. I think that's the bass fishing report. That's the tournament report. Let me look. I don't want to miss nothing. That's it. We'll be coming back with a little more news and come out with a new fishing report. Stay tuned.
Benny's Unlimited Wash Club membership start at $14.99 a month. Wash, rinse, and repeat every day. Join Benny's Unlimited Wash Club at one of Benny's 7 locations.
The perfect event calls for the perfect spread of authentic Cajun cuisine. And Catering Cajun has the planners, packages, and chefs to ensure your event is long remembered. For weddings, corporate lunches, or anything in between, give us a call.
Fishing. It's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
Welcome back to Paradise, Louisiana, and to Berkeley. Abu Garcia, fishing report and hunting report. By the way, I got a short hunting report. By the way, you see rabbit season, squirrel season still going on, quail still going on. We're going to the end of the month of February. They got a couple of goose seasons that go on to the middle of March. So you just stay important, watching us. Here's a good shot of my boys from Bro Bridge here. They had about 14 rabbits, and then I'm looking at this young lady. Lady Alili Trahan. She got a picture of her first deer and a big sackle. And she's been going with her grandmother. And everybody knows her grandmother. Shawn Trahan, she is an ultimate outdoor woman from out in the Butte Rose area. You've seen her killing deer with a bow and a rifle and everything else. And she get after them sackle. They starting to turn on in Butte Rose, all them sloughs and canals. So I might be making a trip there pretty soon. So congratulations. Good girl, Lily. Lily or Lily, I don't know what it is, but I'm gonna find out. Going back to the total fishing report right now, freshwater, it's been pretty good. I mean, here's a young lady you saw on TV last week, Morgan Babin, the little deer slayer, little everything. She was fishing with a retired captain. A lot of people know Phil Robichaux. He took her in a lake and he said, we're going to fish a worm. Taught her how to fish a worm. She caught a 5-pound bass. Good job, Morgan. Keep in touch. Morgan, you ain't seen this guy in a long time. Mark Navo, over there in the Slidell area, and he fishes all in it, Bayou Liberty, and a couple of places. He was fishing in the Violent Marsh. He just now retired with Ernie. Man, they're Franovich. How you like that name? Franovich. Here they are, they caught a limit of bass, caught redfish, and a few specks. Spinnerbait, Violent Marsh. Tom LeBlanc, been going back and forth from over there in Fouchon, and been going back. He finally went back to, because been hearing all the reports. He went to Delacroix, and him and his buddy, they caught a few fish right there, but it still wasn't like he used to, and he was still wondering what's going on. So can't tell you, because I went there one day and they limit out. Next day, we didn't do that well. Slade Abear down in E-Rap, he showed me those pictures of them sackle. Last week, he got a jug line. Now, he been running them jug lines in Bayou Tiger on cut mullet. Here's the biggest one, it's 38-pound blue cat. Falls River is hot and getting hotter. Now, and I can tell you anything about Falls River, about these tournaments that are going on right now, I used to love to fish Falls River. From the middle of February to almost the middle of March, you fish those fronts when in the warm days, when you hear the wind's gonna be changing, you got a cold front coming. We used to drift the flats. I don't know how the grass there, because I ain't been there, but historically, whenever you find grass or you find the shells, I know a lot of things change at Falls River. You float them flats, or you fish the piers or certain ends of the woods where they still got woods, and we fished a lot of jerkbaits. vicious jerk baits around there. They're water about 4 to 5 foot. They move in them shallow. They're getting ready to spawn, pre-spawn fish. There are a bunch of fish in there that bite. So we'll talk to you later on that deal. I almost forgot a while ago while I mentioned Fox River. Happy Wallace, on March the 9th, they got their tournament coming up. Jerry's Land and Fox River, you can get in touch with Will Gotro at 225-278-2626 or Sonny Jordan at 225-573-2421. Now, we go real quick to the saltwater. All the reports I'm getting has been Delacroix. Island Marina still doing real good. Grand Isle is still doing the same thing. You know, the wind lays down, they go fish the rocks, or they go in the back and fish the rocks in certain areas in the marsh. Leeville's gonna turn on, right? This is the time of year they turn on. Catfish Lake, a lot of times the fish will move out there. It starts warming up, Catfish Lake will start getting hot. You'll be fishing some people call it the landmine, sulfur mine, whatever you want to call it. So, and that's it. Don't forget, I tell you, you call Jack, call Miss Angie and them at Island Marina, and they will put you on some fish. They'll tell you where they've been calling. They'll tell you to stay at home. That's one thing Jack did. I heard Jack do it the other day when all that went. Somebody called me and said, "What you think, Jack?" He said, "Wait a few days. Some of these fronts quit doing it. They're muddying it up." So we'll talk at you later. That's it. I got to show you our cameraman. Come here. Come here. This is our assistant producer today. We got another guy. He's been on camera a whole lot. We did a good job, huh? Give me a thumbs up. Thumbs up. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Way to go, Dean the Dream. We'll be back. Come back next week for more report. Thank you.
Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Murphy Law Firm, Veterans Help Foundation, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Louisiana Fish Fry Products, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Louisiana State Parks, Relief Windows, Visit Baton Rouge, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.